performance kind of means a lot to those seniors, and they feel like they're connected to it as well because they were a part of this, and they're a big reason why we're there.
It just allows me to be really grateful for everything, for every day that we have, because they really thought that they were going to go, and now they're not. So I'm just taking this as like an opportunity to really just be grateful, because I'm really blessed to go now that it's really happening just a week away.
At Centerville, there's a saying, Elk pride never dies. There's going to be plenty of families that make that trek to New York City, but there's going to be even more that are watching the Centerville Jazz Band on national TV on Thanksgiving. Reporting in Centerville, James Ryder, News Center 7.
Big sale that hardware paying off. Of course, you can watch the Thanksgiving Day Parade next Thursday right here on Channel 7. It starts at 9 a.m.
I mean, you pointed out, James, that Dante was leaning earlier as if he was bracing against the wind.
Right. It's been so windy. We can tolerate it because it's been so warm. Mm-hmm. I feel so good outside. But that's going to change, my friend. Let's get outside. Let's talk about right now what's going on. It looks oh so good. It looks like Christmas time. Doesn't feel like Christmas time. Christmas time is here. Getting everybody in the Christmas spirit so far. Down in Miami Township, Austin Landing. Looking awfully pretty. But that temperature, 65 degrees. Just off to the west, we got a frontal boundary bringing in the clouds and a few showers too. See off there towards Lake Michigan and up towards places in Michigan, you'll see some yellows in there, some heavier rain showers. We might get some of those as we move into the overnight and first thing early tomorrow morning, but right now we just got some cloud cover out there and a few light sprinkles here and there. That's at 70 and south over towards, looks like Preble County into Miami, or Preble County to Montgomery County, maybe a few light sprinkles. Temperature so far in the lower to mid-60s. This is what Christmas should feel like, if you ask me. 63 in Logan County up in the Bell Fountain. Dayton coming in at 65, Miamisburg 67. That's about the warmest I can find. I'm scanning to see the warmest spot here. I think we'll all just have to flock to Miamisburg until they start to get cooler, then we'll go somewhere else. Winds are pretty gusty, though, as we just talked about. Coming in out of the south ahead of the frontal boundary, about 30, 35 miles an hour at times. So pretty gusty, but then they'll start to subside as we get into the overnight and tomorrow morning, but we'll be a lot colder, too. So it's just going to feel downright cold tomorrow. And then tomorrow night, it really gets cold. All right, so temperatures in the 60s here for the rest of the evening until about midnight. We'll start to dip into the 50s. That front comes in here. The showers move in about mid to late evening. Here are the winds now. Into the evening time, they're out of the south, gusting up to about 30, but you'll start to see this wind shift come in here with this front overnight. So we're still breezy tomorrow morning, not as gusty, but because we're going to be much colder, it's just going to feel cold, too. You'll want the coat tomorrow morning as opposed to maybe the jacket this morning. And then tomorrow afternoon, winds coming in out of the west, still pretty gusty behind this front, up to about 30 miles an hour. Look at that. See how all that warmth just dissipated away tomorrow morning? We'll feel like we're in the lower to mid-30s, and then tomorrow afternoon, really not much change in all honesty because it's cold and it stays breezy. But tomorrow night, first thing in the morning on Friday, teens is what it feels like. Right around 20 degrees. So we are in late November. We're knocking on Thanksgiving's door. McCall's going to have that for you, that forecast for you coming up here at 6 o'clock. So stick around for your Thanksgiving forecast. Few showers coming in here by about 7 o'clock. It turns heavy at times around midnight into the wee hours of the morning. And then first thing in the morning for the morning rush, about 5:30 is when it's heaviest. Then we start to dissipate it about after 8:30, 9 o'clock. We get some peaks of sunshine in the afternoon. We'll call it partly cloudy. But then by tomorrow evening, cold enough air comes in behind this front that we get a few flurries. Nothing's going to stick here, but just a few flying flakes around. And we clear out Friday night. Temperatures drop, and we are staying on the colder side, really, for the long term. So the rainfall amounts, about a quarter of an inch to maybe half an inch here and there, just depending on where we get one of those heavier pockets of rain. So tonight, 40 degrees, scattered showers. Winds are gusty, but they're subsiding. And then 45 tomorrow, a few clouds and showers in the morning. Gives way to partly cloudy skies, breezy and chilly for the afternoon. 45, but we'll feel like we're in the mid-30s. And there's the 7-day forecast where it really doesn't warm up. Sunday's our best day, but it comes at a cost. 51 degrees with showers. And then, oh, goodness gracious, look at Tuesday morning. 23 degrees is where we start off then. Then on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram pages, all of my social media handles if you want to reach out to me. All right, so I've gathered you all together. Boys and girls, gather around the TV set here. I've got a little announcement to make. Mm-hmm. We have had a lot of fun over the past 3 years. James has been picking on me over the past 3 years. A little insult on me. been an absolute pleasure to serve you all here at Channel 7. You have so graciously invited me into your living rooms and have been so unfailingly kind to me. The Miami Valley is just some of the kindest people around, and I'm so appreciative. But my time here is winding down until I say see you later. It won't be goodbye. In the broadcast news industry, we often have to work in cities that we've never heard of, we've never been to, and we try and work our way back closer to home, which is what I did by coming back here to Buckeye State, to this from North Carolina, to this wonderful, phenomenal station here. This station does an excellent job in developing and grooming journalists and meteorologists, and that excels us to the next level in our career. And that has also been afforded me an opportunity because of that to move closer to home, to Northeast Ohio. I'm born and raised in Akron, and so I get the opportunity to work at another incredible TV station in Cleveland. So my last day here at Channel 7 is December 3rd, so you still have me for a few more weeks. But I just wanted to let you all know, the station management has been so kind enough to allow me to address the Miami Valley, to let you know that your support has meant the world to me, and I appreciate it. I'm going to miss you all.
Yeah. Oh, we're going to miss you.
I know the team of our meteorologists. You know, you guys work so closely every day.
Yeah.
And step in when somebody else needs to step out. And yeah, you've been a blessing to us. We've had a heck of a good time.
Likewise, absolutely.
Good luck with those lake effect winds.
Yeah, ever since James found out, he's been teasing you about who was going to be cold up there.
Yeah.
You don't know how much you love home.
And he's
going
right in December, too.
Yeah, great time to go, Dante.
Well, the opposite direction of where I want to go in the warmth. But you know what? Family, though, is everything. Like I mentioned, one of the big reasons here that I'm taking this opportunity along is I get a chance to be closer to family. And I think if we all learned anything over the past couple of years with the pandemic, it's how important family is. And so making this decision, that was kept in mind.
And we're happy for you for that reason.
Yes, that's for us.
We begged and pleaded. Please don't leave us.
Yeah.
And I mean, in the past 3 years, as you said, we've learned how much family means to you.
Yeah.
But I think that the past 3 years also brought a lot of us closer together.
Right.
And Dante and I
absolutely
have this bond, not only because of the pandemic, but, you know, we did the tornado outbreak,
right,
and
absolutely
forever solidify, you know, being the dynamic duo,
exactly,
in my mind anyway,
exactly,
for the rest of my life. But
right,
I wish you the best. I'm so happy for you. This opportunity is something that you could have never turned down.
Right. No,
I'm just happy for you.
And I think what people don't realize out there in TV land is that we are people too.
Yeah.
And there are opportunities that come along that, whether it's in the TV business or out of the TV business, that it just works for you and your family, and you can't turn down. And this was just one of those opportunities.
I think what people, you know, realize is a lot of times we spend more time together here as a family than we do with our families or at the house or across the county or what have you. And a gentleman messaged today. He was, he was upset that you were leaving. And I said, hey, listen, if you put family in front of profession first, that's the best thing you can
absolutely
do.
Yeah.
Anytime.
Absolutely.
I like that Dr. Seuss quote, don't cry because it's over, smile because it happened. You've had us smiling.
Oh, yeah.
And the viewers and laughing
for 3 years. My sister, when she watches, she goes, I can tell that you genuinely are laughing with Dante. She goes, it's not your fake polite laugh.
It sounds like.
I try to be polite with you, but Dante, you're just, and I tell people you're exactly the same off air as on. You're just, you're genuine, you're fun, and you know, we've learned to love you, and but we're happy for you, and
thank
you better
so
come
much
back and visit us.
Yes,
we won't be in trouble.
That's right,
I'm sure. And Dante, you have the social media accounts, so people stay connected with you.
Absolutely.
This is not, you're not severing ties with the Miami Valley.
Right. That's right.
So they can chat with you.
Thank
biggest
you
concern you had moving up to up north?
Casino.
Yeah.
Back into Lake Effect.
Let's talk about the earlier. We need to make sure that he clips those nose hairs.
He's
going
to be breathing through his mouth. This is going to be frozen right here. Right.
You know, but the three-piece suits, they'll keep you warm, right?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm going to have to add an extra layer to these 34 boxes.
A new fashion trend by Dante Jones.
Exactly.
And that box haircut is
right. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm going to drop that picture up. Thank you.
Good man, Fred. Good man. Folks, as we remember Greene County Sheriff Gene Fisher, at 6 o'clock, we look at...